Taking fluid samples and analyzing fluid condition is an essential activity in maximizing fluid-powered, lubricated, and fuel-consuming equipment. Today, there are many methods of performing fluid condition analysis, including but not limited to laboratory analysis and automatic particle counting. Visual evaluation remains an important, simple, and cost-effective way of understanding the overall fluid condition, particularly solid contamination and system fluid. In this two-part video, we will provide best practices for extracting fluid samples directly from a fluid reservoir and step-by-step instructions for visually analyzing fluid samples using the Schroeder Industries Easy Patch Test Kit, or EPK series. The EPK series fluid analysis kit provides the necessary tools to determine levels of solid particulate contamination present in a fluid sample. Using the handheld vacuum pump, the fluid sample is drawn through a membrane filter patch, leaving any contamination on the patch for further evaluation. Any contamination left on the patch can be studied under a digital microscope and compared to photos of known contaminant levels included in the Schroeder Fluid Control Contamination Handbook. Before taking fluid samples directly from a fluid reservoir, it is critical that all related organizational safety policies are understood and adhered to, and that you are properly utilizing all personal protective equipment. Make sure you're taking your fluid sample from a non-pressurized open circuit. This video does not apply nor guide users for taking fluid samples from a pressurized closed-loop circuit. Equipment required to perform the direct sample draw include one sample bottle cleaned to a level at least 2 decades lower than the expected sample, as qualified per the American National Standard Procedure for Qualifying and Controlling Cleaning Methods for Hydraulic Fluid Power Fluid Sample Containers, or ANSI B93.20-1972. Lint-free cloths, handheld vacuum pump or acceptable extraction device, suction tubing, waste container or bucket. Step 1. Find a convenient opening above the fluid level in the reservoir through which the sampling tube can enter. Step 2. Determine the approximate distance from the top of the fluid level in the reservoir to the bottom of the reservoir using a scaling tool, such as a tape measure. Divide that number by 2 and mark that distance on the suction tubing with a marker or tape. Cut the tubing at an acceptable length in which the tubing submerges into the fluid, but also extends out to the extraction device. Step 3. Use the lint-free cloth to wipe the tubing free of particles before submerging into the tank. Step 4. Once cleaned, insert the unmarked tubing end into the Schroeder EPK handheld vacuum pump or an acceptable extraction device, and tighten the compression fitting to secure and seal the tubing in place. Step 5. Tightly screw the sample bottle onto the bottom of the handheld vacuum pump. Step 6. Begin operating the hydraulic circuit. This helps distribute contamination particles as evenly as possible throughout the reservoir. It is important that the same procedure be followed for all similar systems. Step 7. Once the contamination is believed to be well distributed, you can shut off the hydraulic circuit. Step 8. Insert the marked tubing end into the reservoir to the reference mark immediately after step 7. Step 9. Pump the vacuum pump to create a vacuum. Once the bottle is filled approximately 75% of the way full, release the vacuum. Dispose of the fluid in the bottle into a waste container or bucket. Complete this step 3 times to adequately flush the tubing and bottle. On the 4th withdraw, this will give you the most accurate window into your current system and will be the sample analyzed. Step 10. Remove the sample bottle from the vacuum pump and recap immediately as to not collect additional contamination. Before taking fluid samples directly from a fluid reservoir, it is critical that all related organizational safety policies are understood and adhered to, and that you are properly utilizing all personal protective equipment. Be sure to read the instructions provided in the Schroeder EPK in full prior to processing and analyzing a fluid sample. These video instructions do not include instructions for installing the microscope software provided with the digital microscope, nor do they include instructions for installing a filter membrane into the solvent dispensing bottle filter assembly. Step 1. Orient the handheld vacuum pump into standing position and tightly screw up waste bottle onto the bottom threaded connection. Step 2. Pull the nozzle or membrane patch holder from the funnel body. Step 3. Insert the nozzle or membrane patch holder into the handheld vacuum pump and tighten the compression nut. Step 4. Using forceps, place a 0.8 micron filter analysis membrane onto the nozzle or membrane patch holder. Reassemble the funnel filter assembly by pressing the funnel onto the nozzle or membrane patch holder. Step 5. With the sample bottle capped, shake the bottle for 30 seconds to agitate and distribute particles. Step 6. Pour 28 milliliters of well-agitated fluid into the funnel. The first line within the funnel represents 28 milliliters. Alternatively, use one 30 milliliter syringe to measure 28 milliliters of agitated fluid and insert into the funnel. Step 7. Create a vacuum on the fluid by pumping the hand pump. Fluid will begin passing through the filter membrane into the bottle. Step 8. Once all the fluid has passed through the filter, spray solvent around the funnel to capture residual sample contaminants. Repeat step 7 to pass solvent solution through the filter membrane into the bottle. Step 9. Disassemble and remove the contaminated filter membrane from the nozzle or membrane patch holder and place into a disposable petri dish. Step 10. Allow the patch to dry completely before examining with the digital microscope. The solvent applied in step 8 should accelerate the drying process. Step 11. Examine the contaminated fluid patch with the digital microscope and analysis software. Refer to the Fluid Control Contamination Handbook to determine the nearest representative contamination distribution image. This will be the estimated cleanliness of the sample. Step 12. Clean all wetted, reusable components with solvent and allow drying prior to returning to the carrying case. This concludes the two-part instructional video on how to take fluid samples from a fluid reservoir and the systematic instructions for analyzing samples using the Schroeder Industries Easy Patch Test Kit, or the EPK. For additional information and support, please visit us at schroederindustries.com or reach out to us by email at sisales@schroederindustries.com.